Alright, let's just start open up those arms. Give me some circles. Thank you. Hold it here, cross body. All right, kick it overhead. Let's lunge it side to side. Squat it in the middle. Bring those feet in just slightly. Take it up to a tippy toe. All right, grab a sip of water if you want some water. And we should come back with one heavy weight. We're gonna do a dumbbell chop, but with only one weight. Use those loose knees. two more.
Thank you.
Finish two more. All right, don't take out your heavy weight. And I'd actually love for you to turn your step, just like mine is. All right, you got big heavy weights for rows. Take your right foot back, lean forward, reach those arms. Good, reach those belly buttons and pull up to the spine.
Touch, it's my supersonic.
Alright, make sure to
being here, you always keep that heel planted.
As you go down, put the weight in the heel, toes in. Okay, finish one more and pull up your feet. We're going to need a knee off. If you got a heavy weight, let's try a few of them. Always optional. You can always keep the toe down if you need to. Finish two more. We're going to go back to those squats. This time, give me a kick. Down and kick. So, I first want to see that knee lift and then a heel strike. Up. Good. And then as you come down in that squat, make sure your feet are parallel. You can always take the floor if you need to. Two more right here. Hold it. Stay with it. Keep those feet parallel when they come down. Make me kick. Give me two more.
fall. I love uneven because we get so much more range of motion.
There it is. You only have about 5 seconds left. Finish one more on each side. Or two more if you're doing regular. Perfect. Bring yourself up. You're going to grab some weights and press overhead. All right, we're going to do a pulse. We're going to stand up and press. A pulse squat. Pulse and press. Hands here, but you're welcome to bring them all the way down and all the way up. Push those hips backwards. All right, you got two more. We're gonna go back to that repeater knee. Drive
We're going to go into a tricep kickback. We're going to do it in a pendulum. So remember our pendulum, our leg has to stay in line with our body. So if my leg only lifts this far, my upper body only goes down so far. The higher my leg goes, the lower my upper body goes. Okay? So I don't want to see anything here where my leg is dropped. I'm going to lift. Use your glutes. Elbows high, extend. Again, you may not be as low as me. But I want to see a nice straight body. Good. Using those glutes. Extend that leg. Squeeze your quads. And if balance is ever a problem, come into your split stance and work your triceps right here. You can always try a few in pendulum and then bring it back to your split stance. Finish four more. Good, go ahead and drop those weights. Woo, you're gonna give me some lunges side to side. They look just like this. Good. Switching back the legs, you can add bigger arms. Finish up. Let's go to the pendulum on the other side. Have a focus point on the floor. Got it? Begin your triceps. Try a few in your pendulum. And if you need to, drop it down to your split stance. Finish four more. Finish two more.
grabbed, and you got either tap forward or tap your bench. Here we go. Choose whatever speed you like. You can keep it more grounded. Pump in those arms. Go faster without arms. When you put it all together, go wild, go crazy. Woo! All right, grab those weights. Last set of triceps. Last 10 seconds, let's turn those palms up. Finish two more. Beautiful. All right. Let's get down to our mat. On the floor with our mat. All right, it's great if you bring some weight with you, but you don't have to have them. All right, the first thing we're gonna do a sit-up. When you get to the top, you're gonna press that weight into the ceiling. Rolling it all the way down, take it up, press that weight. She can sit really tall here. You're also welcome to have two weights, one in each hand, if that feels more comfortable for you. Good. And if sit-ups are ever too much, you can always just come into a crunch. Two more. Once you finish those two, you're going to drop that weight down. We're going to come into a long lever crunch. That means your legs are straight. And when you come in, your arms can be straight as well, or they can be behind the head. You're going to come in, bring your both knees in, stretch it out. So I love to see your legs cover the ground and not touch. Welcome. Just pop those hips off the floor and come to that double crunch. And remember, you can push high. It doesn't have to be low. Perfect. Good. If it's too much, remember, you can always come to a basic crunch as well. I want you to keep moving. Good. Challenging that core. Press the belly button to the floor as you extend everything out. Give me 4, 3, 2, and flip it on to plank position. All right, we're gonna start with our plank seesaw. So you're gonna be on your elbows. You're just gonna press forward, cinch your toes, and then back. Keep that belly button tight the whole time. Drive that belly button to the ceiling. Good, about 10 more seconds. Finish one more. Take it all the way down. Come into extension. Just lift and lower. See if you get those sides to lift off the floor. Keep your head down towards the floor. Keep that spine in alignment. Good, do one more. Let's back into that plank position. This time we're going to do our dolphin. You're going to press up, push those hips up to the ceiling, squeeze those abs, and come back to plank. Press it up, squeeze it down.
Let's
And you'll sit a little bit higher for our last 10 seconds. Finish one more. And you can relax down. Put those weights to the side. Give me a basic crunch right here. Basic
Finish four more. Here we go. Hips up. Oh, when you're done, cross that leg over. Give me a stretch right here. Take your four stretch. Good. Let's switch that stretch to the other side. So go ahead and release from here. Let's move into a hip flexor stretch.
Thank you.